Jonathon Simmons is a 6'6 shooting guard who currently plays for the San Antonio Spurs. Simmons, in his two-year NBA career, has been a very solid role player for the Spurs, being a very good defender and athlete, as well as being a solid offensive player with the Spurs. And he got lots of attention this year in the Western Conference Finals, as after Zaza Pachulia decided to step under Kawhi Leonard, the Spurs needed guys to step up. The main guy who was expected to step up was LaMarcus Aldridge, but unfortunately, he didn't really do that. But out of nowhere, Simmons stepped up as pretty much the only Spur who hadn't totally given up. Unfortunately, despite his best efforts, the Spurs still got swept by the Warriors. But Simmons established himself as a genuine NBA player, and the story about how he got there in the first place is perhaps the best story basketball has to offer. Jonathon Simmons back in high school considered dropping out because all he knew and all he cared about was basketball. And because of this, he disregarded academics because he didn't see that as a part of his future. But at the age of 16, he was only 5'6". But in his junior year, he jumped up to 6'3", and he started getting recruited by top college teams like Texas A&M, SMU, and Marquette. But because he was so bad academically, he was disqualified from top-tier colleges, so he had to go to a junior college. And at Paris Junior College, he averaged 12 points a game. Then he transferred to Midland College to hopefully shine a bigger light on his game, and that's exactly what happened. And with that spotlight, he again transferred, this time to the University of Houston. And with compliance with the NCAA's transfer rules, he sat out all season. And when he was able to play next season, he averaged almost 15 points a game. But after all of this, Simmons was confident in his abilities, and he decided to skip his senior year and declare for the draft. This was not a good move on his part, because every scout and every mock draft had him going undrafted. And that's exactly what happened. But Simmons was not ready to give up yet. There was a newly developing league in America, creatively named the American Basketball League. The league wasn't at all successful, as it was pretty much full of NBA wannabes, and because of the lack of competition, Simmons averaged 36 points per game. The competition level wasn't enough for Simmons. He was still striving for his NBA dream. So, in one last desperate attempt, Simmons attended a tryout for the San Antonio Spurs D-League team, and he paid a $150 fee to try out. And in the tryouts, Simmons stood out, and the Austin Spurs signed him. And in his first season, Simmons averaged 9.8 points coming off of the bench, but with a higher level of competition, Simmons wasn't standing out as much. And Simmons considered quitting basketball, because D-League contracts are not like NBA contracts, not even a little similar. So Simmons was struggling to support his family, and he considered going back to his 9-to-5 job. This was the closest he had come to his dream, and quitting now would make no sense. So Simmons pushed through the doubt, and in his second season, he was able to start for the Austin Spurs, and he averaged 15 points, 4 rebounds, and 4 assists. Because of this, Simmons was invited to the Spurs Summer League, and he was able to lead them to the Summer League Championship. And with his performance, the Spurs, who at shooting guard had an aging Manu Ginobili off of the bench, he at this point in his career, his body couldn't handle 25 minutes a game for an entire season, so they needed a third shooting guard to come off of the bench. So they called Simmons' agent and signed Simmons to a 2-year deal. After this, John's agent called him and said, "John, you are now an NBA player." Simmons was thrown back by this in a happy shock. He then immediately called his mother to tell her that after years of grinding and years of struggle and disappointment, he had officially achieved his dream. His mother broke down into tears, and now, 2 years later, Simmons is now a free agent, and he can turn that $150 investment that he made in that D-League tryout into what will be tens of millions of dollars in this offseason. Simmons fought his way to the league through sheer determination and perseverance, and because of this, he is a huge inspiration and one of my favorite players in the NBA. Before I sign off, I knew most of this story from hearing about it somewhere. But I got the details of everything from an article by Brian Kotloff, if I'm pronouncing that right. That will be linked in the description of this video. And that's the end of this video. Please be sure to like and subscribe for more NBA content like this, and cue the outro music. I dare you play your cards, boy, you bet I'm a trendsetter too. Fire when the strong pits you. That's it, Brian? Yes.